My very dear Sarah, the indications are strong that we shall move in a few days, perhaps tomorrow. Lest I am not able to write again, I feel compelled to write a few lines that may fall upon your eye when I am no more. I have no misgivings about or lack of confidence in the cause in which I am engaged. And my courage does not halt or falter. I know how strongly American civilization now leans on the triumph of the government, and how great a debt we owe to those who went before us through the blood and suffering of the revolution. And I am perfectly willing to lay down all my joys in this life to help maintain this government and to pay that debt. Sarah, my love for you is deathless. It seems to bind me with mighty cables that nothing but omnipotence could break. And yet my love of country comes over me like a strong wind and bears me unresistibly on with all these chains to the battlefield. Memories of the blissful moments I have spent with you come creeping over me, and I feel most gratified to God and to you that I have enjoyed them so long. Yet hard it is for me to give them up and turn to ashes the hopes of future years. When, God willing, we might still have lived and loved together and seen our sons grow up to honorable manhood about us. Return to my loved ones unharmed. If I do not, my dear Sarah, never forget how much I love you. And when my last breath escapes me on the battlefield, oftentimes been, how gladly would I wash out with my tears every little spot upon your happiness. But oh, Sarah, if the dead could come back to this earth, great dear Sarah. The indications are strong that we shall move in a few days, perhaps tomorrow. Lest I am not able to write again, I feel compelled to write a few lines that may fall upon your eye.